Good morning all of you. In this class, I am going to explain you the fourth phase in the pages of a compiler. So all of you know that we have total six pages. Out of six pages, in this class, I am going to explain you about the fourth phase, that is intermediate code generator. So this is comes under the fourth unit. So all of you know that the analysis and synthesis model of a compiler. What is meant by analysis part? The analysis part means comes under the first three pages, that is lexical analyzer, syntax analyzer and then semantic analyzer. The synthesis part means comes under the remaining three pages, that is one is intermediate code generator, code optimizer and then code generator. So here the front end analyzes a source program and creates an intermediate representation from which the back end generates the target code. So all of you know that in the total six pages are divided into two parts. One is front end and second one is the back end. So the front end means the first four pages, that is lexical analyzer, syntax analyzer, semantic analyzer and then intermediate code generator. The back end means remaining two pages, that is one is code generator and then code optimizer and then code generator. Total two pages comes under back end. So here the front end means it is dependent on the source program and it is independent on the target program. Whereas the back end means it is independent on the source program and it is dependent on the target program. So here in the front end the last page is the intermediate code generator. So here the intermediate code generator generates the output, that is intermediate representation, nothing but the three address code state. So in this case, so this is the logical structure of a compiler front end. So just now I have mentioned that the front end means first four pages. So suppose lexical analyzer, syntax analyzer, semantic analyzer, intermediate code generator. So this is the parser, static checker and this is the intermediate code generator. So till now we can call it as the front end. And the remaining parts we can call it as the back end. So back end means code generator, code optimizer. So here the intermediate code generator generates the intermediate code representations and that becomes input to the backend. So in this unit, we are discussing about the intermediate code generator, that is the fourth phase in our pages of a compiler. So generally, so in the intermediate code generation, we have the output is in the form of two ways. One is the syntax trees and another one is the three address code generator. So in intermediate code generator, different topics are there. The first topic is the variants of syntax tree. So all of you know that how to draw a syntax tree. Suppose if you take A plus B plus A. For example, if you take the statement A plus B plus A, then how to draw a syntax tree? So first one, we have to draw a syntax tree for A plus B. So plus left child A and then right child B. Next one, this part added with A. So plus, so A plus B plus A. This is the syntax tree. So noting a syntax tree represent constructs in the source program. The children of a node represent meaningful components of a construct. And then here, in this case, we are introducing one new graph, that is directed acyclic graph. We can call it as a DAG. So what is the main purpose of the DAG is? So suppose in this case, it is an expression identifies the common sub-expression. So the main purpose of the DAG is to identify the common sub-expression. And also, DAGs can be constructed by using the same techniques that construct syntax tree. So it is also a tree graph as same as the syntax tree. But the main difference is, so for example, take, this is the syntax tree. Suppose take same example, same expression, how to construct a DAG, we will see. See, like the syntax tree for an expression, a tag has leaves corresponding to the atomic operands and interior cores corresponding to operators. And also here the difference is that a node n in a tag has more than one parent if n represents a common sub-expression. In a tree, the tree for the common sub-expression would be replicated as many times as the sub-expression appears in the original expression. But whereas in the tag, not only represent expressions more sufficiently, it gives compiler important clues regarding the generation of efficient code to evaluate the expressions. See, for example, take this statement A plus B plus A, this is the syntax tree. Same way construct a DAG. Suppose in a DAG also, same as how to construct a DAG means same as in syntax tree. But the only the difference is, suppose here in the expression we have first to create a leaf nodes. One is A and another one is B. So like that. So A, B. A, B. Next one, entered this one, added with A. So here we have created A. Whereas in the syntax tree, suppose same number of nodes, we can create any number of nodes, no problem. Whereas in the DAG means, we can create only one node for a particular identifier, Suppose if you take A, node created, B, node created, because initially node A and node B does not exist. That's why we created node A and node B, perform A plus B. Next one, plus A. See, node A is already created. So in the tag, there is no need to create the second tag. But whereas in the syntax tree, we have to create any number of nodes for a particular same symbol. Whereas in this case, it is not possible to construct a node for a same symbol. So node A is already created. So that's why simply you can use the plus. So A plus B plus A. In this way you can construct a tag. See, for example, take one example and construct the directed acyclic graph. So this is the statement A plus A star B minus C plus B minus C star D. So this is the answer. So how to draw this graph? See. So first one, this is the expression. So A plus A star B minus C. So first, we have different operators up there. Plus, star, minus, plus, minus, star. So total three operators. Star, plus, minus. So in these three operators, all of you know that star has more priority when compared to plus and minus. So first we have to perform multiplication operation. So in this, generally we can scan the input from left to right. So A plus A star B minus C. So first we have to compute this one. A star B minus C. Okay. Next one, after that, perform addition operation. Next one we have to compute B minus C star D and then add these two values. So first we have to compute A star B minus C. So first create node A. So node A. So initially there is no nodes. It is a empty. So create node A. Okay. Next one, A star B minus C. Now create node B, because the first we have to perform minus, B minus C. Then only we can perform the multiplication operation. So create node B. So node B, it is not in the list. Otherwise, first create B minus C. Okay. So B minus C. So B, node B, create node B. Next one, create node C, because it is not in the graph. Next one, minus. So B minus C. Next one, A star B minus C. This is A. Node is already created. Next one, perform multiplication. So A star B minus C. A star B minus C. So this part is over. Next one, A plus A star B minus C. So this is A star B minus C part. This one. Next one, A plus. Perform addition operation. Left child is A, right child is entire this value. Now create node A. So node A is already created. So in a DAG, the main important point is in a DAG, no need to create the second time for the same symbol. So node A is already created, no need to create the second time. So plus. What is the left child A? So node A, this is the node A. Node A is already created. A star B minus C. What is the value? A star B minus C value stored at this node. So A star B minus C. Okay. Now this part is over. Next one. B minus C star B. Now create node B. Node B is already there. No need to create the second time. Same way. C. It is also there. Operator minus. So B minus C is there. No need to create the second time. Star B. So perform star B. So star. Left child is B minus C. This is B minus C. And right child is B. B star B. B minus C star B. This part. Now this part is also over. So entire this value stored it here. And entire this value stored it here. Now perform addition operation. So plus left child and then right child. So like this. So in this way we have constructed tag. In a tag almost same as in the syntax tree, but the main difference is in a particular node we have, suppose node A is created and it is not possible to create the second tag. In the whereas in syntax tree we have to create any number of nodes for the same symbol A. But whereas in that it is not possible. It is not possible to create node A second time. It is a unique identifier. Unique leaf nodes. And this is the process. And in the previous class we already discussed about the syntax directed definition. Okay. So this is SDD to produce syntax tree for that. Directed acyclic graph. Suppose take total 6 productions. E2, E plus T, E2, E minus T, E2 T, T2 E, T2 ID and then T2 number. And these are the semantic rules. So all of you know that in a tree, in a syntax tree, generally we are using two functions. One is node and another one is leaf. So node function means we have total 3 parameters. The first parameter is the operator, the second parameter is left child, and the third parameter is the right child. Whereas in the second function leaf, it takes only 2 parameters. One is the type and another one is the value. Okay. So E plus T. So create node, new node plus E dot node and then T dot node. Next one, node minus left child, E dot node, right child, T dot node. Save. So leaf, identifier, identifier value, number and the number value. So this is about the SDD. Next one, and this is the graph. Just now we have draw this graph and this is the procedure. What is the procedure to follow to construct a or to draw a this directed acyclic graph? Now this is the procedure. So the first one, see, first this one. Okay. First A star B minus C. So A. So it is a leaf node. So leaf identifier. Entry A. This is P1. Okay. This is P1. Next one. I mean this one. A. First one is A. Entry P1. Next one. A. same value. So P1. Next one, BC. So BC, leaf B, leaf C, and then create a node like this, B minus C. So node minus P3, P4. What is P3? B. P4 means C. This is the node. Next one, perform this part. Multiplication. A star. So create node star. First one, A. A means P1. Next one, P5 value. Okay. And then perform addition operation. This one. This is the node. Okay. Next one, create. Again, B minus C star D. This one, B minus C star D. So B, C. It is already repeated. P3, P4. Next one, minus. It is already repeated. Next one, identify D. And then perform. No, create a node. So node star P5, P11. What is P5? This part. P11. This one. Next one, node plus this one. Plus left chain and then right chain. So this is the procedure. This is the procedure. By using this procedure, we constructed this directed acyclic graph. And in the syntax tree, the first one is the directed acyclic graph point, and the second point is the value number method for constructing tags. Suppose here, the nodes of a syntax tree or tag are stored in the array of record, array of records, like this. So this is a tag, and this is a array. Okay, so here the expression is I equal to I plus 10. So first one, I plus 10. So I plus 10. Next one, I equal to. So equal to left child is I, because in a tag we create, it is a unique identifier. I equal to enter this value, I plus 10. And this is the array. So stored in array of records. So here each row of the array represents one record. Each row of the array represents one record. In each record, the first field is an operation code. In each record, the first field is an operation code indicating the label of the node. Suppose identifier. The meaning is to enter, to entry for I. Number, what is the value number? 10. What is plus, what is equal to, operators. Everything information is stored in this way. See, the figure B, this one. The figure B, this is the one. So this is the tag representation and this is the array representation. And also here, by using this algorithm, the algorithm meaning is, the algorithm is the value number method for constructing the nodes of a tag. So here the input is label, operator, node 1, node L and node R. So operator, left chain and right chain, that is L and R. So output is the value number of a node in the array with the signature, operator, left chain and then right chain. So here the method is search the array for a node M with label operator left chain and then right chain. Suppose if there is a such node, suppose if the node is there, then we can return the value number of M. If the node is already existing one, then simply we can return the value number of M. Suppose if it is not in the list, then create in the array a new node N with label operator left chain and then right chain and return its value number. First we have to check it whether the node is existing or not. Suppose if the node is existing, then we have to return that value. Suppose if the node is not existing one, then we have to create it and return that value. So this is the algorithm. And the second point is 3 address code. Just now I have already mentioned that the output of the intermediate code generator is one is the syntax tree, one way is syntax tree, and another way is 3 address code. The first point is the syntax tree and the second point is 3 address code. But most of the cases, generally we are using the 3 address code statement only. So the output of the intermediate code generator is nothing but 3 address code. 3 address code. So this is the very, very important topic. 3 address code. So in the 3 address code, we have to learn total 4 points. One is addresses and instructions, quadruples, triples, and then static single assignment form. So these 3 are very, very important. Especially these 2. In the examination point of view, they may ask directly about the quadruples and triples. Quadruples and triples. Okay. So the first one, addresses and instructions. So before going to the addresses and instructions, so first of all, 3 address code general form. Suppose in 3 address code there is at most, so here the condition is at most one operator on the right side of the instruction. At most one operator on the right side of the instruction. Suppose if you take the expression like this, x plus y star z. In this case we have 2 operators, but as per the rule, the right hand side the expression contains at most 1, that means maximum 1, or 0 or 1, maximum is 1, but whereas in this case 2 operators are there. So now our intention is to convert this expression into 3 address code form. So in this case we are taking, so plus star, 2 operators are there, first priority is star, so first we have to perform multiplication operation, because in the right hand side maximum single operator, so this is in 3 address code form, so we can perform first multiplication and this result is stored in temporary variable t1. Next one, we have to perform addition operation. So x plus, this value is already stored in t1. So enter this value is stored at t2. Okay. If you observe the right hand side, the first statement having only one operator. The second statement is also one operator. So in this way, we can construct the given statement into 3 address code form without changing the actual meaning. So this is the 3 address code form. The first one is so here in the just now we already discussed about the graph, how to construct a directed acyclic graph. So this is the directed acyclic graph and now convert this graph into 3 address code statement. So first we have to perform B minus C. So it is already in 3 address code form. So B minus C is stored in T1. Next one, now this value is T1. Next one, we have to perform A star T1. So A star T1, this value is stored at T2. Now this value is T2. Next one, we have to perform addition operation, A plus T2, so A plus T2 is assigned to T3, now this value, this node value is T3. Next one, we have to perform B minus C star D. What is B minus C? It is already calculated, the node value is T1, so T1 star D, it is assigned to T4, now this node value is T4. Finally, we have to perform addition operation, T3 plus T4, it is assigned to T5, it is assigned to T4. Okay, this is the 3 address code statements. Now in the 3 address code statements, The first one is addresses and instructions. So here in the 3 address code is built from two concepts. One is addresses and another one is instructions. Addresses and instructions. Suppose in the object oriented term, we call it as a classes, we call it as a corresponds to the classes and the various kinds of addresses and instructions corresponding to appropriate subclasses. Alternatively, the 3 address code can be implemented using records. So, here the 3 address code is implemented using records which fills for the addresses. Like, records means nothing but quadruples and triples. In the next class, I will explain you how to create a quadruples and how to construct a triples. Okay. And also the addresses can be of the following. One is name and second one is the constant and the third one is the compiler generated temporary. Now these addresses we will discuss in the coming classes. At that time I will explain you. And here the most important thing one is instructions. Most important one is instructions. So the output of the intermediate code generator is, I already mentioned that, 3 address code. Just now I explained 3 address code means it is only one form. Just now I mentioned only one form, but it is in total different forms are there. Total 9 forms are there. We will see one by one. See, here is a list of the common 3 address code statements. Suppose the first one, first 3 address code statement is like this. X equal to Y, operator Z. Just now I explained, in the previous slide I explained this form only. This one only. At most one operator, this one. Single operator, two operands. This is the first form. So X equal to Y operator Z. Where OP means operator is a binary, arithmetic or logical operation. And X, Y and Z are addresses. Okay, this is the first form. And the second form is X equal to operator Y. And the third form is X equal to Y. Generally, most of the cases we are using the first three address code statements. So here the first one is the equal to right hand side. In this case, we are using two operands and single operator. Two operands and single operator. Whereas in this case, we are using single operator and single operand. Single operator and single operand. So in this case, it is a assignment statement, copy statement. X equal to Y, only single operand. This is the third statement. And the fourth one is, see, in the first unit also, we are using only first three address code statements only. Okay. Now in this unit, we have to learn the remaining types also. So here the fourth one is an unconditional jump. Unconditional jump, that means go to. L means label. The three address instruction with the label L is the next to be executed. Suppose go to L1, that means moving to jump from this point to current position to L1. Okay, so go to L. This is the unconditional jump. Next to fifth one, conditional jumps. This is the unconditional jump and this one is the conditional jump. Conditional jump means here we have write some condition. If X go to L and if false X go to L. Suppose E is followed by some condition. Go to L. So go to L means if the condition is true, the L part will be executed. If the condition is false, the indent statement will be executed. I will explain with one example. And sixth one. See here the conditional terms such as if X relational operator Y go to L. So most of the cases we are using this 3 statement. If X relational operator Y go to L. So here the relational operator means all of you know that we have total 6 types of relational operators. Less than or equal to, greater than or equal to, not equal to. So if the condition is true, then go to L. L means true condition. Suppose if the condition is false means next immediate statement will be executed. And also the procedures. Suppose our input is contains some functions, procedures, then how it will be converted into a 3-letter code form. So that is the 7th point. So procedure x1, parameter x2, like that xn. So call p comma n. And also the indexed copy statement. So address x equal to y of y and x of y equal to y. So indexed copy instructions. It is also one type of 3-letter code form. And the 9th one is addresses and pointer assignments of the form. Addresses and pointer assignments of the form. X equal to ampersand y and x equal to star y. Same way star x equal to y. So this is also one type of 3-letter statements. So we have total 9 types are there. The first one is x equal to y operator z. Next one x equal to operator y, x equal to y, unconditional jump, conditional jumps with relational operators like if x relational operator y. Next to procedures, functions, indexed copy statements. Last one is addresses and pointer assignments of the form x equal to ampersand y, x equal to star y, and then star x equal to y. Suppose this is very very important in the examination point of view also. The question may come like input is some code. Just now convert this code into 3-letter form. So the code may be simple expressions only, or the code may contain some program only. In that program, if statements are there, while, do while, for loops are there, and the code may contain pointers also. The code may contain functions also. So how this code will be converted into 3-letter form? The conversion, it is an important process in the examination point of view. So in the next class I will explain you each and every model. Suppose if the input is while, if the input contains some loops, how it will be converted into 3-letter form. Suppose if the input contains some pointers, how it will be converted into 3-letter form. The input contains arrays, the input contains pointers, how it will be converted into 3-letter form. Next class I will explain you. And this is one of the small example. So here consider the statement do while. It is a do while example. So do I equal to I plus 1 increment while A of I less than B. It is a array less than B. Okay, this is the condition. Now question is, just now I have mentioned that input is the code and it will be converted into 3-letter form. So suppose this is the code, given code. Now this will be converted into 3-letter form. So how it will be converted means, so generally two ways. You can use this one or this one. We can use the label concept. Second one is we can use the position numbers, whatever it is. We can use this one or this one. Now I am explaining you two methods. We can follow this one or this one. Suppose a program contains loops are there, better to go to label concept. Suppose if the expression it is a plain text, simple arithmetic expressions, better to go to position numbers. Suppose if it is a conditions or loop, better to go to label concept. Suppose here this is the doer. So first, what is the meaning of this statement? See, the finally ultimate thing is, once we constructed any three underscore statement, the actual meaning should not be changed. Okay, the meaning should be changed. The meaning should be same. The meaning should be same. So first one, the first statement is, see, without, so here this is example for do while. What is the main difference between while and do while? While means first we have to check the condition. If the condition is true, then only we can enter into the loop. What about the do while? Without checking the condition, first we have to run the code one time. After that, we have to check the code. If the condition is true, again the second time code will be executed. Otherwise, it will be terminated. So, at least one time code will be executed in do while. Suppose these are the position numbers. Generally starts with 100. Generally starts with 100. So 100. What is the first statement? I plus 1. So again parallelly it will be parallelly convert into 3 underscore form. It is not in 3 underscore form, means you have to convert into 3 underscore form. So first I want to perform addition operation. T1 equal to I plus 1. Next, T1 is assigned to I. So this part is over. Next, what is the next one? It's a condition. A of I less than B. So I is a location. To take any array problem, the location should be multiplied with number of bits. How many? Number of bits. It is totally depending upon the system. Suppose it may take 4 bits, 8 bits, 16 bits, 32 bits, like that. Whereas in this case, we are taking 8 bits protection. So take temporary variable T2 equal to I into perform 8 bits mission. We are working on 8 bits mission. So into 8. Next one, 103 equal to temporary variable T3 equal to A of I. So I means T2. Next one, 104. If, what is A of I? A of I means nothing but T3. T3 less than V. Suppose if the condition is true, then go to I equal to I plus 1. So that's why go to 100. Go to 100. If the condition is false, then immediate statement will be executed. That is 104. This is the position numbers. Same program represented in labels. Suppose label, this is L. This is L. L. This is the first statement, second statement, third statement. Like that. If the condition is true, go to L. Go to L. If the condition is false, then immediately next block will be executed. Next statement will be executed. Okay. So in this way, we can convert the 3 underscore into the, sorry, in this way we can convert the given code into 3 underscore form. The 3 underscore form we can convert into two ways. One is the position numbers and second one is label concept. In the next class I will explain you with different examples the how the code will be converted into 3 underscore statements. Thank you.